So if we can, please keep the right open. Please keep the right open.
She's just trying to have a, like any little emergency route just in case. So there's about 8 family members that will be here, and of course Pastor Shane. When you're ready, Pastor Shane will give you the list of speakers. He will spell out all the speakers' names so that you have that prepared for your media needs.
You ready?
We have more room over here on this side. You guys want to stand like prom style, like at an angle?
So at this point, the family is going to have to be up here for sure.
Yes. So I'm going to help you angle them up. We have room for like 2 or 3 over here. And whose mic is this? Can I move this down? Are you using it? Because it's not. Over here where you're playing. A few of you want to step up over here. You can make some room. Right here. Over here. So you guys can all squeeze. There's two that can come in on this side if you like.
Yeah, I'll leave it to the top. Okay. Want the other one? In front.
Certainly, first of all, we're going to begin at this time. I'm Reverend Shane, S-H-A-N-E, Harris, Reverend Shane Harris, President of the National Action Network. We are here today to address the killing of another unarmed black man in this country, Alfred Belongo. And certainly, we are thankful to the leadership that is here today. Certainly, we want to give honor to the children who are here. Tammy, call the number one. Okay. So, Sheree, the daughter of Alfred Belongo, is here with us today. I wanted to be very clear as we begin that we appreciate the leadership of Attorney Diggs, who is here from Los Angeles, and Attorney Dan Gillian. We pay homage to the father and the mother of Alfred. Certainly, as I begin, I want to begin by saying that this is a tragedy. The fact that we now have in this city a representation of what we've seen around the country, I think that it only shows the ignorance of the city. The fact that this city, in so many ways, can be so constantly arrogant to think that because we have palm trees and beaches here, that we don't have any issues here. And the fact that Alfred, who we believe was unjustly killed by police. We are here to say that this killing, we do not believe is justified, and we believe we must proceed with civil rights because it is very clear to us that he was attacked and he was not given the opportunity to live. I'll say this, and then I'll introduce the attorneys, and then the mother's gonna come. We are here to stand with the family. When they reached out to National Action Network, it was very important to us that they are protected and that it is very clear what they have asked. They've asked for people to speak up and use your voice, but please do it peacefully and please do it non-violently, because anything else represents this family and Alfred in a bad way, and it does not represent what he represented. We're here to say today that what Alfred represented was peace, was love, and the way that they're portraying him all over the country, we want it to be very clear that that is not the Alfred that we have come to know and that this family knows. The way that they're portraying him around the country will not be the narrative that is framed. We will frame the narrative because we understand who he is and we understand what he represented. So I want it to be very clear. We do believe that Alfred Olango was unjustly killed. We do believe that the officer who shot him 5 times did this with misconduct. And that is why we are here today. We are here to address the injustice and the fact that he would be killed this way, and we only can get a photo. But yet and still, the country's begging for a video. We can only get a photo of him pointing his hand without a gun in his hands. He did not have a weapon. He did not have anything to hurt anybody. And that's been confirmed. We are going to proceed a fight for justice because we believe that Alfred Olango was unjustly killed. And we believe that there must be not only something done, but this family must let his legacy live on. And we cannot have violent protesters, and we cannot have non-peaceful protests. We are calling for peaceful, effective, and strategic protests so that we can get the justice that this family is seeking. At this time, I bring forth the attorney who is not the representative of the family in the legal matter. The family is still pursuing legal and a legal infrastructure. But the attorney that has helped us a lot uncover the legalities and the concepts of this has been Attorney Diggins. And he's going to come forth at this time and address you at this time. Attorney.
Thank you. Good afternoon. My name is Rodney Diggs, attorney at the firm Ivy McNeil & Wyatt, located in downtown Los Angeles. What the family wants today is justice, because the unlawful killing of Alfred was an injustice. Dr. King said before, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere, as we have seen during the past few months. We've seen this recently in Tulsa, we've seen this recently in North Carolina, and now we see it again a couple days ago in San Diego. We have to hold those officers accountable for violating the rights not only of Alfred but of his family. The Fourth and the 14th Amendment, those are protections that every individual is entitled to. We can't have officers going acting as judge, jury, and executioner. That's not the way. And so what the family demands is justice. We want answers, because the use of deadly force that was used against Mr. Olango is wrong, and those officers will be held accountable. We don't have many facts. The facts that we do have is that Mr. Olango's sister called 911 3 times. And the only question that they asked, what race is it? Why is that relevant? She needed help. The officers are there to serve and protect, and they did not do that. What they came within an hour after she called and killed Mr. Olango within a minute. That's not justice. They heard that it was a 5150 call, and so there's proper procedures and policies that these officers have to follow. They didn't follow those. Instead, they shot him 5 times. And they don't want to produce the video. All they want to produce is a still photo that meets their narrative. But as Reverend Harris said, we are going to change that narrative because we're going to get down to the truth and find out what happened to Mr. Longo and get the family the justice that they deserve.
At this time, another person who's been so helpful in the whole process has some very important information that he's been displaying and dealing with concerning the cop and the history of the cop. And he's going to come forth to share at this time. And it's none other than the attorney, Dan Gillian.
Hello, everyone. Dan Gillian. You know, I think that whenever, you can imagine that whenever a family loses a loved one, the last thing in the world they want to be doing within 48 hours is having an attorney come up and start talking about the case. This family should be grieving. But unfortunately, attorneys are required to fight back against what the El Cajon Police Department in the city of El Cajon, and I think in some part, Bonnie DeManus, are doing in the media, which is litigating this case in the media. And the reason I say that is because if they wanted to, they could release that video. And so many questions would be answered. Instead, what they did was they selected, they cherry-picked an image of Alfred in a stance with his hands pointed towards an officer. His name was Richard Gonzalez. And that's the image they want you to see. And that's a wonderful image if you're litigating a case in the media, because it allows all the talk show hosts and all the experts across this country at this point to talk about what happens when you take your hands out of your pocket and act like you might be shooting a gun. It fits a perfect narrative for them. It's really unfortunate that we have to be fighting back against that narrative. This officer, his name is Richard Gonzalez, he used to be a sergeant with the El Cajon Police Department. He got busted down to a police officer recently. And the reason he did that is because he had the mental capacity, sort of cowboy sort of thinking, that said, you know what, for Richard Gonzalez, it's okay to take a picture of your genitals and text that picture to your subordinate females, to one of your police officers. You know what, for Richard Gonzalez, that's perfectly fine. And what else is fine for Richard Gonzalez? Go and text some messages over the course of a year inviting sex. The same sergeant, a young female officer. Richard Gonzalez did not have a right to do that. I believe it was probably criminal. But for whatever reason, the El Cajon Police Department decided that it was worthy of maybe a demotion. I think anywhere in the country that's worthy of being terminated. They didn't do that, and I think this cowboy mentality that he already displayed was somehow solidified by this department. You know what? Got caught doing something, been doing that, we're going to bust you down to a police officer. Now go back to work with that police officer and make her life hell. That's what we're facing in El Cajon. That was the person that went out there that day responding to a 5150. It means they know that this person is having mental issues. He shows up. He knows that every single rookie, much less the PERT team, is taught that what you do in a situation like that is not escalate it, you de-escalate it. You don't confront the person, you decompress the person, you talk to them, and you stay covered. We know that didn't happen, even though we don't have the video, because we know that within a minute, Alfred was dead. This cowboy decided to go out there and take care of things once and for all. So, that's why we're here. I'm giving legal guidance to the family on what they might be doing, and my first legal guidance was to change this narrative, or at least fight back against the narrative, because you know what happens when images are put out there. I think everyone here remembers a white Bronco 21 years ago. 2 years from now, potential jurors might remember Alfred standing there pointing his hands at this officer, and might remember, you know what, maybe he had it coming. Isn't that what this case is all about? It's totally unfair for this DA to authorize that still image and not allow that video to come out. Totally unfair. And that's why we're here. Whether or not there will be a lawsuit, that has not been decided. I've been talking the last 2 days to a number of different news agencies out there, and one of the things that keeps coming up that needs to be cleared up once and for all is this notion that somehow Alfred was mentally ill. It is true that the 5150 call was placed, and that when these officers arrived, they had evidence, and they had a belief, that this person might be mentally ill. But Alfred was not mentally ill. He was going through a mental emergency, a mental breakdown, because he had lost someone that he loved dearly. We all go through bad days. I don't know if someone with my skin color would end up dead because they're having a bad day. But that's what happened here. He was unarmed. And the fact that the Elkhorn Police Department rallied behind this officer a year ago and didn't fire him and allow him to be out there with a weapon, a badge, the fact that they rallied behind him back then just begs the question, is maybe that's why they're rallying around him right now. Maybe that's why they posted one single image create a narrative for all of you to show to all the viewers out there. And that narrative needs to change. There's police procedures that we could figure out whether or not they were followed if it simply released that video. And I think that that's the most important thing that we demand right now from Bonnie Demands. Stop playing games, Bonnie. You're not informing the public. You're misinforming the public. Thank you.
Finally, and then I'll come back and give the direction on what is to happen next and what the family is asked next, is a woman who has been the strongest of us all, the strongest woman in this family. She's the rock of this family. She's holding it down. And we want it to be very clear, she, if anybody knew Alfred, she knew him. And it's the mother of Alfred Olango, Pamela Bengay, make sure I say the last name right, Bengay, spelled P-A-M-E-L-A-B-E-N-G-E. The mother of Alfred Olango is going to come forth now and tell us the real story about who he was.
Struggling. I know they mentioned, I heard that, yes, we're refugees, yes, we're refugees, but that doesn't justify that we should be killed because of being a refugee. He had no weapon. I know I'm telling you the truth. My son is a good, loving young man.
That's right, that's right.
Only 38 years old. I wanted his future to be longer than that. I wanted him to enjoy his daughter. We have come from a war zone. We wanted protection. That's why we're here. I want the children not to be running around, being fear every night, sleeping in the bush. And that's why we're here, yes. Being a refugee, I know there are millions of refugees that are here just seeking for a better place, a safety place. That's all. Safety. We wanted this to be safe. But now, I ask the question, where should we go? I don't know. I wanted, I thought, a lovely, nice country like this would protect us. We just need protection. That's all. This, my son, did not kill anybody. He lost the most privileged best friend. People deal with their receipt of death differently. He couldn't hold it the way I held mine. Tell them, he just got out of it, so he was not mentally ill. Never. He loved to play soccer. He loved fun. Every time he do a joke, he loved his daughter. He loved the daughter. So my mom, I love my daughter. I want her to be everything. I want to do everything what I can. You know, even if maybe I've gone wrong, I am here for the family. You know, I'm now growing up. I want to be a great father. He was never meant to be. Yeah, no. Losing a bad friend can lead you to this. He broke up. He couldn't handle it, so that's why he couldn't handle it. He was just running around. So, not even with any gun or anything. Just, I think his mind was just not communicating. How could he even understand anyone coming? Mental breakdown is not easy for growth. It needed someone who was growing just come to down and then take care of the situation. That's all the call was called for. Not to come and just finish his life. There is nothing as painful. It is the bitterest thing in life. Pain. It is so much that you cannot swallow it. You try to swallow it, but the pain overweighs you. It is so bitter. Bitter than anything else. It's pain. I am with only everybody that has gone through losing their son through officers, and they cannot give them a chance. Why not could you just only teach them all just certain days, and then take care of what you want to get? At least he would be recovered from the hospital. I would still go and talk to him, hug him, say we are here, okay? We know you lost your friend, but in one time. You're trying to hang on.
Yes.
You're trying to. I mean, all the people that are trying to support my family, I thank you so much deeply from our hearts. But we want peaceful. Let's be, I'm always for peace. I don't want war. If you have seen war, you will never, ever want to step near where there is war. Running through war, I think people here have not gone through it.
Yes.
If you could pass that, we would all be said we are human.
Yes.
We are all one.
That's right.
No color, no red, no white, no black. We all have the same human. Humanity is what we praise for.
That's right.
But because maybe people have not gone through what we have gone through, you don't know how painful it is being through the war zone. I pray that it doesn't hit here. Otherwise, you will come to realize that what that woman said one day, really, it touched the heart, and she had gone through it. Not easy. You go without food, you don't know how you're going to take care of your children, you don't know what is going to happen next, and here you come to see for, you think that I'm here now, see, I will get justice. What I'm asking for is keep praying for my family, please. Yes, I've been praying for all of you, the mother that loves your children, pray for us so that we are strong together. But we need justice.
Yes.
This kind of thing needs to stop.
Yes.
instead of handling how to do things the right way.
Yes.
Can we not do that as human beings?
Yes.
Really? Really? What if it touches you if you don't feel the pain of someone else that's going through, then you are inhuman. That's how I see it. But if you are human, definitely it needs to touch your heart and change. Don't wait until it's my child or it's my cousin. We are all one.
Yes.
We all, if I say, I can record, we came from Adam and Eve. That's what God has created.
Yes.
One.
One.
Then we migrated. Come on, let's be human bear. Don't kill, but we will not kill. Some fellas kill and they still bless them, they don't kill them. You take them through the justice, that's all we need to take people according to the justice. Let us have proper justice.
Yes.
I live in justice. I always hope that this country is the best and they will really protect us and give us the best justice everyone deserves. Here we are, our cry. Be with us. Pray for my family.
Yes.
We are all praying for you too. Regardless whether you lost yours 10 or 3 or 4 years ago, it still comes back, that pain.
Yes.
It is so hurtful. Because those who just support or go behind them, they don't feel it because they have not gone through. Believe me, one day, if it could touch them, that's when maybe they will open their eyes. But we need to open our eyes, our hearts, to be united as peaceful as possible, as everyone else in the world. I'm begging the whole world, not only people here, help us correct the situation. Let us be in one system, justice. Treat everyone with justice,
yes,
properly. That's all I ask for. If you support me and my family, just peaceful. I need to go there and show your support for us, but peacefully. I don't want war. Don't go at the borders or give destruction of property of anybody.
Right.
Let's not do that. Let us ask for peaceful demonstration.
Right.
If you get so, that is okay. It hurts. That's why you try to show it, but don't hurt anyone.
Right.
So that we can be hurt, so that we are respected. I am a clean hearted, very happy, and that's what my son got it for me. For me personally, everybody from work called me mommy because of my character. I don't hate anybody, I don't discriminate, because I believe in everyone as human being. What I always beg for, I thank you so much. So if you are here, you hear me, know that my son was not killed. He was not killing around. He did not do it, he had no gun. He was not mentored. No, he had just mentored. Break down. There's a difference.
Yes.
Please.
Yeah.
Difference.
Yeah.
We can all know the difference. So don't tweak it. Don't twist it. Just be sincere. I love sincerity, please. It is all there. You know, if one person has done something wrong, don't protect him. But when he's out, better. Because if he's still there, it's not going to stop on me. He is going to kill another person again. I'm telling you, because it becomes unhappy. He killed and he lived that he has done justice, he has done right, justified, and yet we can see that it was not justified. Well, he will do it again because we're supporting it. So how can we improve? I just want everyone so that no loss again should happen. I don't care about the color, but I don't want any more individuals to lose their loved ones. It is so hard. It is so painful. It is not easy to go through it. No, you want to try to just be there and you are the part of that that you wait until you are old and be there by your side. But not to just bury them. So be with me. If we are going to just go to protest, demonstration, it is going to be peaceful.
Yes.
I am just for peace. Support my family for peace, for justice. That's all I need. Justice for Huffley. Only. He is the best. If you knew him, how happy and joyful he was. Yes, he was a joyful man. He loves to be as well. There's nothing much. I don't want to say much. Whatever they can say, please, those who want to listen to me and support me peacefully, I welcome you. Everybody's calling me. I appreciate it. We all, the family as a family, we appreciate that so much. You don't know how it means to us. Deeply from our heart. We thank everyone that's trying to support us. Let's keep going just for justice so that it brings a change. We don't want blood to keep pouring. It's too much. It's too much where I come from. I went through seeing it. I don't want to see it again. I saw my son. I don't want it again. I've been seeing some of my little mothers there going through it. I don't want it repeated. We don't want it. Please, let's close it down. Let's close it down for my justice. Let's for justice so that the people that killed and then started meeting and out of their job and trained better people. Thank you so much for those who are going to support us. Bye-bye. May my son soul be in peace.
Let me say this in closing. And certainly we give honor to this mother. Her strength is incredible. We, and I'm reaffirming this, firmly believe that Alfred Olanko was killed and his life was taken. Few things that must be identified is that the calls that went to 911 on that day, you're supposed to come and help us when we call you, but we can't get you here for an hour and a half. But then when you're after us, you can get us in a couple of seconds. Something is wrong when we can reach out to those who say they're here to protect and serve, but we can't get any protection or service. And today we are here to identify the facts that we know. We know that on that day, that 911 was called three times. We know or have heard that there have been questions that have gone forth about the questions that she was asked about his race. But I think the biggest point that must be identified, and the mother made this very clear, you cannot take a breakdown and say that somebody's mentally unstable. There's a difference between one momentary issue and a long-term issue. And what they're trying to paint Alfred as is somebody who had long-term mental illnesses. But we came to flip the script and tell you around the country that Alfred is not the way that they're trying to paint him. Alfred is not mentally ill, nor was he unstable. Just because we have moments, that does not mean that that is who we are. And we will not let the paintbrush go that way. We will correct the script, and that's why today is the beginning of the movement. People around the country are watching this. Mind you also, you must point out that San Diego now, this county, is the only city in the country that a district attorney has total control over videotapes being released. And we want to say that if you can put a photo out, we want you to release the tape. Where's your nerve and your guts at now? We need you to release the tape because the tape shows the whole picture and not just a part of the picture. We don't trust this. And I think what we've seen in all these cases, just got in from Tulsa, Oklahoma with Terrence Crutcher. We're watching it around the country. Local prosecutors cannot investigate local police. We cannot trust them because they won't do it the right way. Federal DOJ must get involved in all these cases because it's clear as day that the local prosecutors have failed us. They failed us with Trayvon Martin. They failed us with Michael Brown. They failed us right now with Keith Lamont Scott in Charlotte. They're failing us around the country, and I don't expect this district attorney to do any better. I hope she will, but we don't expect it because she's done it on several levels, and every single time she has not done what she's supposed to do. This tape must be released now. We want the story to be told right and to stop being told wrong. A picture cannot identify the whole case, and I've never seen it. In all of my time in activism, I've seen cases left and right. I've never seen a picture released as the quote of evidence about what happened during a shooting.
Right.
Something's got to be done, and we want the video released. We are not going to wait on calling for that video, and that's why the next step is Saturday. The family and National Action Network and others have called a unity rally that will be held in El Cajon. In El Cajon, the family is going to join us. We are going to peacefully and nonviolently march the streets of El Cajon, and we will demand justice for Alfred Orlango. We will also make it clear, Saturday will not just be a day for El Cajon. We're calling on people around the country to go to your local DA's, district attorney's office, and hold protests there and speak up and use your voice for Alfred Orlango. We're calling a National Day of Action and Justice for Alfred Orlango Saturday. And Saturday, we will hold a unity rally in El Cajon. Several are going to come from across the state and are coming from across the country. Reverend Sharpton has already announced it on the national radio show. We are going to pursue justice, and we will pursue the facts, and that's what we want today. We want the facts. We don't want stories. We don't want lies. We want facts, and that's what we're calling for today. And we're calling on people around the country to get behind Alfred Orlango. On Saturday, we need to hold a National Day of Action for Alfred Orlango, calling for the tape to be released. And not only the tape to be released, but the facts to be released. We need a fair and impartial investigation, and that is what we do know we want. Certainly, as I close, it is very important that it's very clear that we are calling on nonviolent, peaceful protest. And that's why Saturday we will march, we will speak up, there will be a National Day of Action across this country for Alfred Orlango. Alfred's life will not go unnoticed. His life will leave a legacy. And this family is not only going to fight for Alfred, they're going to fight for those who have experienced and have seen deaths around this country, from little boys to big adults. There's a problem in this country when it comes to policing, and we must have legislation that deals with police in this country. Police must know that if they hold misconduct, that they will have to pay the price. And that is very clear today. So as we leave here today, I want to be very clear. This family is struggling. People are hurting. I've seen a lot of baseball games. I've seen a lot of hurting moments. I watched a baseball game with a young man that used to go to my church when I pastored a church. And he was playing this game a few weeks ago. He got about to the last inning. Looked like they were down a couple points. By the last inning, they were tied in the game. Pitcher threw the ball, and the same boy that was discouraged in the beginning of the game, the same boy who wanted to give up, the same boy who wanted to throw in the towel, was the same boy who got up to the plate and hit a home run. And we want you to know that this may be a down moment, but it's not an end moment. We're going to fight until the end, and we're going to seek justice around this country for Alfred Orlango. His life will not go unnoticed. His life will not be left aside. Thank you. No questions.
We're not allowed to take questions. We've been listening to you for me. Specifically, we want to know about the picture. Reverend, that's a little unfair. Can you come back and answer some questions then, Reverend? Because I agree with you.
Some of the other clergy members answer questions if you don't
understand. Has
anybody from the DA's office offered to show you the video?
The Reverend, it's not okay. It's unfair for us to do this whole thing without. Can you come back and answer some questions for us?
Nobody can answer questions, not even the attorneys.
Well, we just
have
some of the other clergy members if you're reluctant to do so.
There's an ongoing investigation.
Reverend,
we understand that. We want to clarify some details.
We have two questions.
Talking about transparency and clarity.
I'm mean, we don't want to need to talk to the family. We understand that they're in grief, and we understand that. But Reverend Shane Harris, you have called this news conference. Can you just answer some questions? Certainly you're adept at that. We just want to know about two questions.
Wow.
Okay.
You guys, I'm going to watch the anime again.